Yes, welcome. Today we're going to be looking at independent events. In the previous class, we talked about mutually exclusive events, events that cannot happen at the same time. That two events that cannot happen at the same time call it mutually exclusive event. But events that can happen at the same time call it independent events. Exactly. So the probability of having two events that can happen at the same time is just by multiplying the individual probabilities together. Is it? Unlike that for mutually exclusive, where you have to add the individual probabilities together. Exactly. So this is the probability of two events that can happen at the same time. Example, clapping your hands and singing. Can you be clapping your hands and be singing? That's what is done in the church, is it not? You go to the church, you'll be clapping and you'll be singing, isn't it? So clapping and singing are two independent events. They are independent of each other. Doing this one cannot stop you from doing this one. Exactly. So events that doing one will not stop you from doing the other. They are known as independent events. You understand? When you are above the age of 18 or 21, they say you cannot be even independent of your parents. You understand? Your parents are doing their thing. You are in school, be your thing, independent. You understand? Things two of them can go on at the same time. So, independent. Okay. Now, the probability of such events are multiplied. They are done what? Multiply, and that is why it is called multiplication one probability. Let's take an example of two things that can happen together. Example, two dice are thrown once. What is the probability of getting 2 6? If you throw two dice, you know what dice is? They have six parts, isn't it? Six parts. Is it possible for you to see a 2 on this one and at the same time see a 2 on this one? Yes, it's possible. You understand? So, what is the probability of getting 2 6? For you to see a 6 on this die and also see a 6 on that, it's going to be the probability of seeing a 6 on this die, which is 1 over 6, isn't it? Times the probability of seeing a 6 on this one, which is 1 over 6 as well, is it? So that's why we have 1 over 6 times 1 over 6, which is 1 over 36. Is that clear? Is that clear? Now, what is the probability of getting 2 prime numbers? What is the probability of getting 2 prime numbers? What is the probability of getting prime number in 1? You know how many prime numbers are in the dice between 1 and 6 is 3. Is it not? So the probability of getting prime number in 1 is 3 over 6. Is it not? So what is the probability of getting prime number in the other one? Still 3 over 6 because there are 3 prime numbers in 1 die. Is it not? So it's 3 over 6. So we're going to have 3 over 6 times 3 over 6. 3 over 6 times 3 over 6. Give us 9 over 6. This is 1 to 1 to 1 over 4. Is that clear? Now, what is the probability of getting 1 odd, 1 even? 1 odd, 1 even. Is it? What is the probability of getting 1 odd and 1 even in 1? What is the probability of getting 1 odd and 1 even in 1? 1 odd is going to be 3 over 6, is it not? And 1 even is also going to be what? 3 over 6. So it's going to be what? 3 over 6 times 3 over 6. You understand? Then on the other one, the probability of getting 1 odd and 1 even is also going to be 3 over 6 times 3 over 6. Is that clear? And you know that you can be having 3 over 6 in 1, 1 odd, 1 even in 1. Look at how I made the statement. Either odd on the first die, even on the second die. Is that clear? Or you have even on the first die, odd on the second die. Can you see that? Can you see that? So it's either odd on the first die and even on the second die. Odd on the first die is 3 over 6, isn't it? Even on the first die is 3 over 6. So you multiply the 2. Or you do what? Add. This is add. This is and. Whenever you have and, it's going to be what? Multiplication, right? Good. Or you have even in the first die, or odd in, and odd in the second die. You have this. So it's either you're having this situation or this situation. So you have to add up when you finish multiplying. So you have 9 over 36 plus 9 over 36, giving us 18 over 36, which is 1 over 10. You understand? So this is the, this is what they say. What is the probability of having one chord, one cable? The possible things you can have is that in the first die, you can have that either on the first die, even on the second die. That's what you can have. Either on the first die, even on the second die. Their probability is this. Or you can have even on the first die, or on the second die. This is their probability. 3 over 6 times 3 over 6. So if you have 3 over 6 times 3 over 6, it's going to give you 9 over 6. 3 over 6 times 3 over 6 is going to give you another 9 over 6. 9 over 6 plus 9 over 6 is really 18 over 6, which is the same thing as 1 over 2. Is that clear? Please, if you like this video, click on the subscribe button, like and share our videos. Thank you for your time. Next class.